Welcome to the BioWolf Bash scripting class. In this section, we will explain a bit about the environment of your shell. As discussed previously, only some shell features are propagated to subshells. These include your current working directory and environment variables. This video will discuss the environment and its implications. The environment is a special set of variables defined in a shell that can be propagated to child shells. Many of these variables are critical to using Bash. Processes very often query the environment while running. An environment variable is actually just a regular variable that has been elevated with an export attribute. A shell function can also have this export attribute. You should be aware of the environment of your shell. Environment variables can be displayed in a few ways. Printenv command, declare -x, and env. Let's demonstrate these commands. The printenv command is the simplest method and shows a long list of variables. Note that both the name and full value of variables and functions are shown. The arguments passed to the printenv command are evaluated as environment variables, and their values are printed in a list format. For example, I can query the variables home, user, and pwd in a single command with printenv. The declare command is the canonical way of creating and manipulating variables. It can be used to list all variables exported to the environment by including the -x option with no arguments. It also sorts the variables alphabetically, making the display a bit easier to understand. Lastly, the env command is used to manipulate the environment on the fly, but can be called with no arguments to display environment variables in the same manner as printenv. Typically, you will see users run both printenv and env interchangeably. Functions in the environment can be seen as well, using the declare -FX command. As I said earlier, the declare command is the canonical way of creating and manipulating variables. The -F option causes declare to show only the names of functions rather than variables, and the -X option shows only those exported to the environment. Because these options are single letters with a single hyphen, they can be concatenated into a single string. You can see the module function, a very commonly used function on the HPC cluster, listed among the functions exported to the environment. Source setup files, such as /.bashrc, are typically used to set the environment of a login shell. These will be explained in more detail in a future video. A previously created variable can be made exportable in a few ways. Declare -x and the name of the variable, or export name of the variable. More commonly, variables are defined and exported in a single command. Export name equals value. A variable can also be created and exported to the environment specifically and directly for a single running command. For example, setting the temperature direct environment variable for an application that utilizes large amounts of local scratch space immediately prior to running the executable command. Temperature equals lscratch slurm job ID command followed by several arguments. In summary, be aware of the environment that you are using in the shell. Be cognizant of what is necessary and what confuses processes. Keep in mind that the environment can change the behavior of an executable's output. Thank you for watching, and if you have any questions or comments, please email us at staff@hpc.nih.gov.